Hello guys, and welcome to my new Total War 3 Kingdoms playthrough. I've decided I'm going to play as Mateng. Sorry, just a little bit of information. My Mateng playthrough will be posted on Tuesdays and Saturdays. I do also have another playthrough as Yuan Shao, which is getting posted on Wednesdays and Sundays. And then also my main campaign is Liu Bei. Which is getting posted every day. So my Liu Bei was a one night start, Yuan Shao was a 200 base divided start. So you've got plenty of content coming out at the minute. Hopefully I can keep it up. Playing as Mateng, I have played as him once before. I didn't completely finish the campaign, to be honest. I got pretty bored. But I am interested in using his unique units, and I do believe he's got a couple more now as well. So, Mateng, I believe his dad was a minor official in the Han Empire, but I think because of some dispute with like the where he was living, like a more major official, he moved to the Liang province with his parents, and he grew up in poverty. So I think he was selling wood to make a living. And then as he sort of grew up, the people of the Liang, so the Qiang, I don't know how you pronounce it, Q-I-A-N-G, people, they rose up against the Han. So people like Han Sui and a few others were involved in that. Mateng volunteered to fight for the Han. And then when, obviously, sorry, he got recognised because he was a very talented fighter, obviously. And then when his leading general died, he switched over to the rebels. And eventually the rebels was pushed back. But to keep the peace, the Han gave some of the leading officers of the rebels titles, which is how Mateng kind of rose to power. He is the protector of the West, so I do believe he was involved in, you know, fighting off a lot of Western Chinese rebels and, you know, Mongolian people, say. I believe he is a governor. Where does it say? Okay, so he's the protector of the West. His playstyle focus is cavalry and military supply, so again, you know, I'm looking forward to using these guys. Starting situation is hard. Now, that is because we start off at war with Gongdu, and he's got a pretty strong army, but there is a way of dealing with him. It's, you know, some of you might not like it, but it's just an easy way of dealing with Gongdu, which I will show you. Obviously, his early dilemma, well, I won't talk about it too much, but I don't think I'm going to follow the story, because again, it's just ridiculously hard and you will just get absolutely wiped, more than likely. But we'll see how we go. So, I'll just turn the volume down on the headset. I do need to reorder the roach. Which is good. Right, it's faction. Foraging and supplies, army forage food running camped, increasing military supply bonus. Okay. Could come in back handy, might not. His unique features, so he's got three pretty good unique units showing here. Again, I'm really excited to use him. So the Qiang Marauders are shock cavalry, which we can use, any character can use at rank 1, and they are pretty strong. And then we have the Qiang Hunters, which level 3, so available at level 3, again, very strong. And the Qiang Raiders, which are melee cavalry, which are really, really strong. So there is a way you can play this, where you get all the horse pastures and a few of the reforms, you can pretty much have free cavalry, because where you get 20% recruitment and upkeep cost for Keng units with my Teng. So I'm not sure if my child gets that. We'll see. So our unique building is the Xiliang supply lines. So you get food from foraging, cavalry, recruit rank, military supplies for friendly horses, and military supplies for hostile horses. It's probably something we won't be building too much of, and is loyalty to the Han. So you cannot declare as emperor by creating an emperor seat. So, you know, I would like to kind of follow a story, my own story kind of thing, kind of roleplay, and keeping loyal to the Han. We'll have to see how that goes. So the noteworthy character is Ma Chao, obviously his son and his heir. Very, very good officer. So Ma Teng is loyal, just gives him some expertise. The others don't really count because, well, they don't count because he's a faction leader. He's careless, so 15% chance of avoiding ambush, so gotta be careful there. And he's cruel, which is very bad. Just give him some instinct. So pretty nice, but the minus four public order is, it's not brilliant to manage, but we'll have to manage it. And he's a vanguard. So we'll be playing on legendary 60 minute battle time is. And we're playing a romance. So that's about it, guys. Let's get into it.
Embers rise, stark against the night. The tyrant Dong Zhuo wields the flames of destruction. Luo Yang burns, chaos ignites, as the power of the eunuchs is crushed. In the pyre, the Han falters. Yet the chaos is nothing compared to loyalty. Ma Teng prepares, knowing he will follow the Emperor to whatever end. The Han Dynasty must be protected. China is in turmoil. The great empire of the Han, stretching back ages beyond counting, is being devoured by corruption. The Yellow Turbans, thousands strong, began raising their banners in rebellion and seizing commanderies across the realm. In response, generals loyal to the Emperor rose up and put down the rebellion.
I'm gonna have a look because I do feel like the SSD should be a lot faster than this. So I'm gonna have a look for a faster cable, I suppose.
Yet, despite the victory. The capital burns, Lord Ma Teng.
The noblemen fight for the throne, but they ignore their empire, their responsibility.
Dong Zhuo has taken the emperor west, to Chang'an.
This is wise. Dong Zhuo has removed him from the chaos. Now the Emperor can rule without those insidious eunuchs.
Yet there is still civil unrest. The Yellow Turban insurrections persist.
Ever am I called to destroy China's enemies. Very well.
Han Sui may aid you, my lord. He has been a staunch friend.
He has. Yet friends rise and fall. The Empire must not.
Long have you been the sword that holds back enemies without. Now you must turn your blade on the enemies within.
So, establish your power, we have to remove the other term threat, which is the Samia, and be wary of Dong Zhao. So, okay, mission issue. Ma Teng finds more enemies to vanquish. So, engage the following general in battle, which is Wang Du, and we get a taste of victory. So, some morale and 30 military supplies. So, as you saw there in the cutscene, Ma Teng is pretty naive to trust Dong Zhao at this stage. We do start off in an alliance with Han Sui. What a trade agreement giving her. Okay, 360 now. We won't sign that just yet. We start off in alliance with Han Sui, which may end up changing. We also start with a non-aggression pact with Dong Zhao, maybe? Yeah, non-aggression pact. So, Ma Teng is pretty loyal to the Han, as you can hear there. He wants the Empire to stand, which is the playthrough we're going to play with. I don't know. Again, if we're going to take the initial dilemma, we'll have to see. So, ancillary wise, a brown for a bread, a scholar. Okay, that's pretty good, and a wooden axe. So, look at our unit. So, we start off with Ma Teng, which we've already gone over. He does start off with.
Trust instinct.
A family spear, which is okay, as well as some decent armor, which gives him a charge bonus, and he's got a 60 armor base, which is very strong. Just start off with reach and flexibility, which again is awesome. We also have Pang Di, who I do believe should be a legendary character. He was a fairly good officer. Starts off with flexibility, so we're probably going down the line of reach and then obviously trust. Again, he's got a bronze armor, which is 60 armor base. It does give him an expertise debuff, which is not awesome. And we also have his wife, Ma Teng's wife, so Hua Lendi. She's my wife for now. We do plan on divorcing her and marrying her out. But we won't do that straight away. So just give her a 5 satisfaction for being charismatic if we make her our heir.
She's also got the clerk, so she'll give her -2 construction time.
He gives 12% melee damage for all shot cavalry, which could be pretty strong. Okay, he does have unbreakable and fatigue resistance as well. So, pretty strong, so we'll have a look at our family tree. I think Ma Chao is our heir at the minute. He's only 14, he's not come of age yet. So I think we're going to make Hua Lengli our heir for now. She'll give that +5 satisfaction and... The building up trait, so minus two. Does she also give an assignment? So what we'll probably do is we'll give her some authority boost for the satisfaction boost. Give her that for now as well. Give you that, and we'll give Candy the William Arts. Okay. So our first battle is against Wangdu. Should be a fairly simple battle.
Shape and guide passion.
It's unknown, but I think Pangli should let it deal with him pretty well. So we will fight it.
Unleash fury!
Obviously try and minimize casualties.
Fortune smiles upon us. Let us not squander opportunity. I don't think
it matters because we probably will disband a lot of the units.
No more honeyed words. To the fight.
Again, I do have some editing which would probably still have to get a faster cable, but the editing software I have at the minute, we can't upload it to 1080, so I am going to have to purchase the main version of it, the upgraded version, just to do that. But it is going to cost me money. I mean, I don't mind spending a bit, but I hope you all understand that until I start making money through YouTube, I don't really want to overspend. You know, just the computer and everything else is expensive enough. So, you know, it is. You don't just pay money for the actual. You basically pay for subscription, so the yearly subscription, which makes it quite expensive. I probably will do that just for the enjoyment of everyone else. Okay. So what we will probably do here is we'll just try and level up our generals. You guys will hide in here. We may bring these guys. Try and get them some experience through the forest. You guys come here. Start.
Though retinues can split and separate during the battle, some effects are still shared.
Okay, you should absolutely smash him with a hamstring as well.
Make haste! Move out quickly! Strike! Move! 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 Your rebellion is over, scum! Must I cut out your tongue before killing you? Run! Run! Move out quickly!
Yeah, use that pretty much straight away.
Charge at the double! Hurry! Move! Kill them! Unleash fury! Faster! Go, go, go! Run! Double time! Ready to battle! Horsemen! Faster! We will not relent!
So now it's got the charge there.
Fight!
Okay, both of these are
make ready!
Run! Some free
I
kills.
Am so far deeply unimpressed.
Please, you stop. Pretty decent, man.
You're humiliating yourself. Prepare. Steal yourself. Steal yourself. Take heed, warriors. Horses. You are too pathetic to survive. Have you eaten lately? You look gaunt.
Are you charging to them first from the side? Shut them.
Move!
Let those guys charge in.
Shit! Make ready!
So now it's just a case of forwarding. My thing probably would have killed him by now. Perhaps I should have swapped the weapons. Definitely should have swapped the weapons.
Take heed, warriors!
He's covered in blood, even though he's took more of a battery. Okay.
The enemy general is fallen!
Shot with a one staff. So, no losses. Obviously, Pangy did get take a bit of health loss. But overall, simple victory. Thank you.
heaven rewarded our passion. Free the prisoners.
We got a taste of victory, so some surprise as well as Bacorda. Morale, sorry. So the border warrior solidifies his control, so take we do, get support from the people. Glorious victory. We do have a level up on D. So he is already fatigue resistant. Suppose that giving it to his retinue. But we're going to give him reach. Okay. So, let's see how that deals with Dong Zhao. Still 369. I think we can get more than that.
Spread in all directions!
So, as you can see, we'll start out.
No. This is what you train for!
This is why this campaign is so hard. So Gongdu is here. Basically, we'll take Wudu. Gongdu will defeat the Han. And then he will retreat to the copper mine. If we have a lot of units. But what we'll probably do, we'll probably disband everything apart from Mateng, Pangdi, and the two Kang Marauders. Let's have a look. What is this? Settlement saying. Yeah. So we want to entice him to attack, basically, and then we just
stoke passions and strike.
We can't attack it. Yet. Oh, we can't attack it. Sorry, we are just sieging it now. So, because I'm going to end up disbanding these, I'm going to delegate, probably take more losses than what we'd like. These are raiders. These are immune to fatigue. So, I don't know, do I fight it? I want to take minimal losses on my cavalry, Mateng, Pangdi, so I'm going to fight myself. Not very too fussed about losses on the archers and the Magi infantry. Obviously, the cleaner we can fight this, the better trade we'll get with Dong Zhao as well. So what we will probably do... We'll probably start our two generals here with Kang retreats. And then as well as 2G retreats. These guys just to try and spread them out as much as possible. We'll put you here. So, start the battle. You guys come and take this. Okay, they're spawning in the center anyway. I guess it doesn't really matter.
Our men have been discovered!
Make ready!
Okay. You charge in here, and then you guys are going to charge in there. You guys come here, just to give me some backup.
Again,
you guys charge in there. Give me a nice clean charging, please. Strike these guys.
One step closer to victory!
attacking Tate's tower. Yeah, he is getting hit. He's pretty bad by the towers. These are pretty persistent. Look, the enemy right won. To take minimum losses. Oh wow, did you just walk through there? Great. Okay, I'm going to get a rear charge on them, please. Chase them around.
The enemy warriors are running!
Okay, we continue chasing down, but definitely don't need. So about 100 losses. I don't know what they did. It took in the auto result, probably similar, to be fair. But the important thing is, Pangy still has a lot of health, so I can use him in the next battle.
Heaven rewarded our passion.
Fine
settlement. We'll take it.
Okay, so we've got support from the people.
So construct or upgrade a building for your economy grows. Some buildings have to be for my time. He must be close to leveling up now. Surely. Yeah, not far. Okay. Okay, so we've got some decent stuff there. We've got the military G, which, to be fair, we can put it on Pangdi. We probably won't. So now what we do, we trade.
Welcome, friend.
$156 from him per turn, which is pretty good.
It is agreed.
Now, do we get military access from him?
The honor is mine.
So 242 plus 156, so 400, say. Plus 371, so that's 771 a turn. Not bad at this stage. So we're going to propose that deal. Now, another bit of diplomacy we're going to do. We definitely don't want to become a vassal. We're going to try and get Hansui's trade. Sorry, Silk Trader. And we are going to trade it off for the horse trainers. As well as that, we will try and get the Silken Spice Hanzong from Dongzhou. As well, Sandpass also. That will also give us a boost eventually when we get that one too. Okay, so let's have a look.
Welcome, take a seat.
If we give you that for that, minus four, now we give you some ancillaries. So we'll give you the brown for a bread. So
glad to see you.
Okay, we have to wait one turn. Also, that's a plus four. So we can do that. And what about Dongzhu over here?
Welcome, friend.
Take this because we don't have the pass. Why is it untradeable? We have no way to get to it, right? Okay. Okay, so for now we will just trade with Hansui.
Welcome. Take a seat.
Incinerary. No, it's not worth a lot, so we'll keep the weapon. We don't want the horse, and we don't want the stone pig. We don't want your money.
We accept this.
But we do want the silk trader. Okay. So Andy, I'll give you this new weapon. Okay, so what we are probably going to, well, what we will do now, because our mission, we have the replenishment mission. But we also had a mission to, which gives us the construction buff.
Peace through conquest.
Okay, so first of all, what we do is we expand these units.
Caution! Douse is the heart's desire.
And we'll put Hannah Hanlew in. So that's a level 2. Right, we end the turn. Gongdu will attack us.
Attention!
But all we're going to do is going to kite him round the settlement. So end the turn. Cheesy way of fighting this, guys, but it's the easiest way, to be fair.
A fire burns in my soul, ceaseless and strong. Prepare, knave. A reckoning comes.
Okay, so Gongdu is starting over here, which means okay.
Attend! Ready!
You guys. Thank you.
them to get wrecked by these towers, really. So, if you guys just start here. Okay, start here, we'll see what they do. You are going to be my 2 force, and you're going to retreat into these woods. And you are going to come here and come out. Or do I retreat into the woods as well?
To attention.
Archers can be deadly support troops. They have a long range, and if flaming arrows are available, can cause panic among the enemy.
Quick march! Watch out! The enemy lies in wait for us!
Okay, so you kite them over to you, Pandy. No, they do have fire arrows. You guys come away over here. And so they are burning down towers. They will take losses though. So this is a bit of an exploit in the game. I understand why some of you wouldn't like it, but just for this particular instance, he's a pain in the ass, Gongdu and Zankai. Come over this way a little bit. Because can they ride and shoot? They can. The quicker they get taken out, the better. Can speed it up a little bit. Okay, that's one unit retreating.
The enemy unit flees! What cowards!
Obviously, it'd be better if we could, if we'd probably set up a couple of Xiling or Shang marauders just to try and beat these back and possibly even Mateng.
him back in range. Let the towers do their work. They're going to start firing. Put themselves down. Okay, awesome. So what we probably want to do here, we do have to be wary of when the infantry retreat. So we're going to want to get some distance. We do want to keep them, these guys, pretty close. He's not going to reach them. He may reach them, actually. Still have more health than what I'd have liked. That's the issue. Yeah, he's not going to reach them. If you go for that... You get a good charge on them, boys. Okay, but that is some Guardians of the Land defeated. At least. We whittled them down a fair bit. Just finish these guys off. And then the battle. If we can finish them off now, definitely should. I don't think we will better though. Probably should have kept some of our troops.
resist corruption, and endure hardships.
I think we'll take the ransom again.
I will show mercy this time.
Selfless, intrepid, intimidating. Okay. Okay, normally we should have got some incineraries there, but we didn't. So, which way do we go with you? Look at the faction support. Don't we? Okay, so if we attack him now, the balance of power is strongly in our favour. We can reach him. This time we should get a haul. Okay, and we delegate.
With utter belief, and you will be undefeatable!
Okay, I thought he started with the mace thing. We could either take the 400 income, or the military tree. I think we're going to take the military tree.
They shall cost us no more.
Again, let's take the replenishment.
Hopefully. As they fight side by side, your general's bonds will deepen as friends or rivals.
So now we wipe him out.
Let feasting commence!
Take the income this time.
Free the prisoners!
Okay, now we got a haul. Okay, all those are coming pretty handy.
Marching,
get back if you can. You can't.
Passion cannot burn indefinitely.
Now, build up this silk trader.
in the Silk Trader. Next turn, we build up our army. It'd have been nice if we can get back.
There's barely anybody here.
Do we recruit you? I think we do. For now. Because we will use her in a second. Okay, she's not very happy. Okay, now you get back to Udu. Some more incineries and a brain snake. You're done.
To duty.
Put up to level 3. I'm sure we had a mission to Okay. So now what we do, we recruit. Okay, you don't like Pangdi, that's fine. We'll recruit her though. That will spark the mission if we do some diplomacy. And do we have, no. Okay, the Han Empire let us.
Glad to see you.
Okay, so 210. Or just straight up 172. We'll take the 210, please. Now that should strike the mission. Did it? No, okay, we'll have to wait till next turn. Okay, we don't get the recruitment cost, it's just replenishment.
Trust instinct! Spread throughout.
Okay, we're going to give that to Hua Handi. The extra satisfaction boost. Okay. Do we build them now?
Get the recruitment cast. Probably should have given it to her because she is unhappy. Okay, end the turn. Okay, so now we have the replenishment, and we will recruit a trap. First,
follow the heart. To war!
Tomosh, we did get the water clock, so we'll give that to... give that to him. Fix replenishment on, on him. Now we'll give him General of the Right. Okay. Do you have the reform? Oh, shug. I've messed up. I could have got the recruitment cast. One of these, doesn't it give like a massive boost to silk and spies? Okay, it's that one.
My courage reach as high.
Oh, I could have got a massive massive decrease in the cost of this. So you, okay, you're looking pretty good.
For China.
I think now we've done most recruiting, we'll just get the trade agreement. And obviously trade with Han Sui.
Well met, friend. Very well.
Okay, we end the turn.
attention!
Okay, we put in the gem at the right. Okay, we'll do that actually.
I am at your disposal, my lord.
Swap you over to General of the Left again. Give you some more of these guys. Give you another archer. Okay. Can we build? Not quite.
The population is stable.
Hmm.
Channel passions.
Chiming Pass will give us both silk increase to Hanzong and Udu. This guy has a decent garrison. I'm hoping he attacks us, really. You're really not happy. We'll give you this for now. Does anything else give you satisfaction? No. Why are you so happy? Okay. End the turn. Get some more replenishment.
Passion. Setting the trap.
Probably will just wait one more turn now. Okay. We can build the inn. I think we want to wait until we can improve this. She starts coming back next turn, so if we bring her back, in fact, made a mistake again. Okay, end the turn. He would have probably been a better general. Didn't realise that he was going to come of age. Okay.
Standard
do we
stance.
Go on the attack?
Obey instinct!
Start them out.
With fury.
Sun Jian's dead. No one interested. Few dens come of age. Okay.
In the name of China.
A bug that keeps happening as well.
The honor is mine.
Both of these passes will give massive silk bonuses to both of these. So, I do believe there may be another pass. No, there's Wu Pass. Not sure if that's linked to Hanzong. Okay, again, we're just ending the turn. First of all, get the assignment ready. Here, for the construction cast. Next turn, we build up the silk. Okay. Now we fight them.
We march now for something greater than ourselves.
Let battle come. I shall greet it alongside you.
Okay, Mateng does have the charge resistance.
They are cloaked in anonymity. Be mindful.
Your words are empty. Save
Hopefully
your
we can get a win here.
Make ready! Take heed, warriors!
Okay.
At the ready. Steal yourself.
Let's see what we can do.
Your generals are the most vital soldiers on the battlefield. Each one has their own
what they're waiting for.
Faster!
Okay, here they come. Nice.
Do not waste your breath. You will need it.
Might have to draw one of them. I think it was. The middle one. Where's their calf?
Your lack of competence is breathtaking.
I will crush you for this insult.
Nice. Getting some good kills. Okay, so both of their cav is gonna come around.
Stand ready!
No.
Enemy warriors are running! Ha! Fight! Attend! The time has come! Attend these spearmen!
Prepare! Move back! Quickly! The time has come! Destroy them!
Cavalrymen! Destroy them! To attention! You are weak!
Thank you.
attention!
All things considered, there's a battle I was expecting to lose. I should defeat an officer here.
Make ready!
At the ready!
Stand ready!
Okay, the trebuchet was outstanding, which you'd probably expect. Oh, lucky. Can we get a few? No, oh, so unlucky. Matenga, I thought you was fatigue resistant. Claim victory. Okay. Decisive victory, which is obviously good.
Your war has brought you to the very gates of your enemy. Behind their walls, they steel themselves against your armies. They cannot hold out forever. Yet an assault may be costly if not swift. Yet wait too long, and reinforcements may arrive to relieve their embattled comrades.
Oh, come on.
Let feasting commence!
Okay, good win there. We'll take the replenishment, please.
Duty awaits!
Should let delegators win now.
Unleash fury!
Yeah, we'll just delegate this for the defeat of Gongdu and the four settlements as well.
Our victory was just.
Yeah, we'll execute you.
Consider this a mercy.
Okay. So you gain momentum, so we got a minus 20% recruitment cost, which would have been handy last time. Another 20%, so we got that for 6 turns, okay. And the next mission is to reach second marque. We've got the commandery, and the last rebel remnants are destroyed, so we've got Path to Glory for that. So public order and peasantry abuse, which we don't actually have any peasantry income. Okay. Destroy following faction Dong Zhao.
Peace through conquest.
We don't have any assignments. So yeah, we're going to make this into a level 3. Pengdi has gained a rank, which is obviously awesome. Give him the armor. We also got the Great Glaive. So all these are going to come in handy because next we defeat Huang Du.
I cannot.
Be nice if he takes this. Cost 8,000. Wow. We'll go down this route. I think we're probably going to marry her off anyway. Okay. So we have 6 turns to recruit. I think what we'll do is we'll disband 2 of these. I want to keep the Treb, but 3 turns.
What do you wish, my lord?
She happier now? She's happier. Swap him over to General to right. Okay. So, our income so far is... We get an extra 15% income from silk. Yeah, so basically we want to defeat Huang Zhu, Zhanglu. I want to trade for the silk trader. And then we'll be pretty happy with that. Obviously, we want to make this into a food settlement, so we do want to take this probably as soon as possible.
Order must be obeyed.
So we're upgrading that with the other assignment there, so that's good. Once that's upgraded, we'll get an inn. potentially. Okay, I've got plus one. So I've got a negative six. Why? Faction support. Okay, that will go down. Okay, so end the turn.
I have a request for you.
I'm going to reject that.
It is your decision.
Okay. Silk post is done. Build us an inn, even though... See, silk is a unique resource, isn't it? So it doesn't really matter too much. We could focus on, or we should, okay, we have a reform. We could negotiate trade with Liu Yan. Now we are going to recruit some more troops. So probably we'll get the negative 8%, and then we do need to build ourselves a county school. That is probably what we'll do, actually. Build a county school in here, which we can't. Why? I have no idea. I have to... Okay. Let's build an inn. Okay, our form-wise... Do we trade with Liu Yan? Potentially, because I don't think we're going to be going up against him. But no, we'll go for this there. Okay, so now you go to here.
Purge doubt.
And then we'll recruit to the infantry and... One of them. Okay. Four turns to replenishment. I in the turn. Hopefully, Zhang Lu will appear up here somewhere.
We would not be your enemy.
We're going to reject that, I'm afraid.
Curious, but acceptable.
We just don't need him yet. Flat 100. Four turns on you, two turns on you, four turns. Okay, we end the turn.
Fire burns brightly and indiscriminately. But no flame can last forever. Starved of air, it chokes, it splutters, and is then extinguished.
Okay, so Tanzhao's dead.
The tyrant is dead. Yet in the ashen darkness, the avaricious prowl.
Okay, so Dong Zhao is dead. Dong Min takes over. I think we're going to end this episode here, guys. So thanks for watching and tune in for the next one. Remember to check out my Yuan Shao playthrough as well as my Liu Bei playthrough as well. You'll find them on my YouTube page. So thanks for watching, guys, and bye-bye.